Good morning to all of you.
Good morning, sir.
Hello, sir. Good morning.
In the previous class, we have seen about the school development plan, and we have also seen about the state policy in Orissa about the school development plan. Okay, so what are the state policies are there that we have already seen, and I hope that the detail about the state rules about the right of free and compulsory act 2009 must be discussed in the unit 2, because that is the main content for the unit 2. But here we have to see only the what are the recommendations, what are the rule for the school development plan. Okay, but when we see about the school development, when we talk about the school development, one of the things that is a very important to discuss, that how we will plan for the school development. Like that, we have seen that the school development plan is a blueprint, or it is a framework. Okay, and that are obviously very specific. It is a specific to the context, it is a specific to the school, even it is a specific to the time. But the thing comes that how we will decide that what should be the thrust area, what should be the focus area for the school development plan. Because at random we cannot plan anything, we cannot execute anything, we may find the difficulty in executing. So that needs to be thought out. And that's why the last bit of this unit says that the addressing the issue in the implementation of SDP, that is the school development plan. So how we will identify that the issues, what are the issues? Then the third bit is that the actors and their role in the preparation of SDP. Actors means the different stakeholder. Actors means not that is the hero heroine kind of actor. Okay. Abhineta, abhinetri, not that one, but actor here is the different stakeholders. Those are the stakeholders of a school development plan, like teachers, like a headmaster, like a school development management committee, like that. So what will be their roles and responsibility? So how we will understand? So for that we will see here two approach. One approach is the process approach that we will see, and another one is the SWOT analysis. Okay, so I think we can start with the SWOT analysis also. So how many of you have heard of this word, even that SWOT analysis? Do you know that what is this SWOT analysis?
Yes, sir.
Yes, Pallavi. Tell, what is that?
Sir, so strength, weakness, opportunities and threat.
Achha, strength, weakness, opportunity and threat. That is the full form. I am not concerned about the abbreviation. Thoda sa usko aur explain kijiye, if you can.
सर इंस्टीट्यूशनल प्लानिंग में किसी एक इंस्टीट्यूट का उसका फर्दर प्लानिंग के लिए उसका स्ट्रेंथ वीकनेस इसको सब मेजर करके जो प्लानिंग बनाया जाता है.
अच्छा, स्ट्रेंथ वीकनेस को मेजर करके जो प्लानिंग करते हैं, दैट इज द SWOT
analysis. ये चार के बेसिस पे प्लान होता है, इनका मतलब इन्हीं को नजर में रख के करते
हैं, इन चारों को कंसीडर करके प्लान करते हैं. इज दैट यू आर ट्राइंग टू से अंशुमान?
यस सर.
ओके, एनीबडी एल्स? बिकॉज़ आई सी दैट दोज हु यूज्ड टू रिप्लाई, दे आर ओनली टेकिंग पार्ट इन द डिस्कशन. Others, those who are silent, they keep their mouth closed.
Strength, strength.
सर द पर्सन विल कीप अ रिकॉर्ड ऑफ स्ट्रेंथ वीकनेस अपॉर्चुनिटी एंड थ्रेट्स एवरी डे ही विल नोट डाउन दीस फोर थिंग्स ऑफ सर्टेन पर्सन एंड दैट वे ही विल फॉर्म अ डाटा ओवर मल्टीपल डेज सो दैट इज व्हाट एनालिसिस इज यू सी वेदर द स्ट्रेंथ्स हैव चेंज्ड वेदर वीकनेसेस हैव चेंज्ड वेदर थ्रेट्स हैव चेंज्ड वेदर अपॉर्चुनिटीज हैव स्ट्रेंथ चेंज्ड फॉर एग्जांपल इफ समवन वीक इन इफ अ स्टूडेंट इज वीक इन मैथमेटिक्स यू माइट विल पुट मैथमेटिक्स इन वीकनेसेस बट आफ्टर 5 टू 7 डेज इट बिकम्स अ स्ट्रेंथ सो इट विल गो इन द स्ट्रेंथ सो यू कैन टेल दैट द टीचिंग ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स इज इफेक्टिव So they keep a record. Every day you have to note down what is the strengths, weaknesses, threats and opportunities. So that we can form a record over multiple days.
Okay, you are Soumya, you are correct, but the context is a little bit different. It is not a totally different, little bit different here. Thoda sa different hai. Because I know and we understand that the SWOT analysis are being done in a different field. Even we used to do when we plan anything in our career, in our life. Even suppose that you are planning for your career. Okay, so that time also we used to do a SWOT analysis. That is, what is my strength, what is my weakness. In that, what are the opportunities and what are the threats? Okay, so that we used to do, but here the context is a bit different, not a much, but it is a bit different. So, one and two response more I will try to take. So, I think Chitra is silent since a long time. So, may I get your response? Are you here, Chitra?
Yes, sir. I'm here.
So, can you speak something about that?
Sir, जो उन लोग बोले वही तो लग रहा है मुझे कि it is a kind of a technique where failures को in confined करने के लिए, restrict करने के लिए, limited करने के लिए we used to follow this technique. SWOT analysis, where brainstorming tool or something, some tools have to be implied, where the thing has to be restricted and more improvement is
okay. So I think it's better that I should start about the SWOT analysis. Actually, when we talk about SWOT analysis is the analysis framework. Okay, it is a analysis framework to understand the planning that we are going to implement. It is an analysis plan. Okay. And the analysis plan is specifically for planning purpose, because whenever you find an challenge or whenever you want to do a work, suppose that for very specific example we will take from the school. For example, you are trying to improve the teaching learning situation environment in the school, in your school. Suppose that you are a headmaster and you are trying to improve the teaching learning environment in your school, or you may be a teacher even and you are thinking of improving the students' achievement in the subject which you are teaching. But in order to improve, whether you are a teacher or whether you are a headmaster, in order to improve the planning that you had, you are required to understand several things that is prevailing. Several things means something are that which is inherent, inbuilt, that you cannot change. And that inherent and inbuilt may be something positive, something desirable, or something not desirable, which is not desirable. Both of things will be there, and you don't have a control over that. Like that, for sake of example, you are a headmaster of a school where the children's from agriculture sector, agriculture laborers are coming. So majority of the student will drop out when the agriculture season will come, like this time. Some days before, some I think 1 month or 1.5 month before, we had a season of planting a paddy. Okay, so and this is the kharif season, it is said in the agriculture terminology, and the rabi season when we used to produce a wheat. Okay, so majority of the children will drop out, so that will be one of the hurdle in providing a quality learning opportunity to the student, improving the learning achievement of the student. So that may be one of the hurdle. Or you may be like that in a field where electricity connectivity is very poor, or internet connectivity is very poor. So that is the inherent. You can't change in general, or you can't change over the night. Or changing this thing is not in your hand. So there are several variables. Like that, in some society, it may be problem that they don't want to send the girl child to the school. Okay, that may be the problem. Or it may be the problem where the lack of teachers are there. So there are some problems, there are some undesirable, not here to term as a problem, because in every situation there is an opportunity. So the point of saying is that these are the inherent. It may be desirable or undesirable. Desirable, what it will be? Even the strength of a teachers are very less, but they are very dedicated. They are very promising for their work. Even the students are from the agriculture sector laborers, but they are very talented. They are very motivated to learn, very interested to learn. So that may be again one desirable thing. So these both are the inherent things. And whenever we are planning for something, we must plan by considering these two things as it is, because changing these things is either not easy, or it may not be possible to change in a very short duration of a time. Suppose that a recruitment of a teacher, you are not appropriate authority, and you cannot expect that you will get a desirable teacher's strength in a very short period of a time. You will write the authority and you will get. No, it may not be. And in the most of the cases, it will not. Because we know that in the government sector, there is a very serious crunch of the teaching staff at all level of education. So, that one. So, the SWOT analysis framework for analyzing about the planning for improvement says that in order to plan anything to implement, it is not only used in the field of education, it is also not only used in the field of the school management and administration, it is widely used in every field. इवन दोज हु आर स्टडिंग द मैनेजमेंट लाइक अ एमबीए और अ बीबीए मास्टर ऑफ बिजनेस मैनेजमेंट दे ऑल्सो यूज टू स्टडी अबाउट दैट बट दे स्टडी इन अ मोर डीपर सेंस ओके सो द पॉइंट ऑफ सेइंग इज दैट when we talk about the SWOT analysis first we have to understand that what are the inherent things are available there and inherent here I am meaning the things which is not possible to change in a very short duration of a time so first we have to think about see that what are the desirable things that are available there desirable things may be that you have a good strength of a student you may have a good teaching faculty dedicated teaching faculty those who are committed towards the teaching work it may be that the SMDC school management and development committee are very much cooperative and supportive and they are interested to develop the school as a model school it may be possible that the ambience of the school location of a school is very good means the student from a different part they can come to the school they can approach to the school very easily or it may be also possible that the school have a very sound infrastructure so like that there are various things that are very much desirable so you have to list out because when you will be planning you must see that what are the things I have and what are the things I don't have like that the weakness it may be possible that the childrens are coming they are from a very low socioeconomic strata so you have to work hard with them to motivate to come to the school you may be suppose that they are since from very low socioeconomic strata so you may think of supporting the student by the mean of a scholarship by mean of the free textbook by mean of the free other supporting material like a bicycle paper pencils copy midday meals like that so here because we are planning now so in order to plan we must see both the things what are the opportunity available and what are the undesirable weakness are available rosalyn you are joining
so late network issue oppo phone ke itna network issue oppo phone ke itna
acha 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 okay 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 so we must see the both the things only seeing the weakness will also not be sufficient only seeing the strength will also not sufficient so by analyzing by listing out these two things we have to go for the opportunity so in this situation in this desirable and undesirable components whatever the desirable things are there whatever the undesirable weaknesses are there how we can proceed what should be the opportunity within that because we understand there is a always a opportunity in every adverse situation even when we talk about this pandemic when the schools and education institutes are closed we have opportunity we have learned we have developed that how the online classes can be organized more effectively and the most of the teachers who were not competent enough because it has been identified by the several researches also that the majority of the teachers are not competent enough to organize online classes. But now they have developed some sort of competencies. I have seen many teachers also. Even I find that there is an improvement in myself. Even I find that you have also improved yourself in attending the online classes. And you have also devised, you have learned so many things. Because I remember when the AMED presentations was going on, most of the students were unable to present, unable to manage all these gadgets. Those who were not having the laptop, they only were having the mobile, so they were presenting by the mobile, and since they were unable to understand how we can share the PowerPoint through the mobile. So they were sending to me and we were sharing the PowerPoint from here, and the students were speaking from there. But some of them, they have learned how to do with the mobile even. So there is always an opportunity. Whatever the adversity is there, whatever the problem or hurdles are there. So the adversity. Okay, so within that, what are the opportunity you have to list out? What we can do, how we can do, within that how we can proceed. I am not telling that if you are in the remote area, so you should plan for the using the ICT gadgets, internet and computer, all those things. No, you can't. But within that framework, how and what we can do. That is the thing. So that opportunity needs to be listed out, and accordingly we should make a plan. But before the implementing the plan, we must understand the threat, because whenever whatever we are planning, there may be again inbuilt. I am not saying that you are doing knowingly, purposefully. But sometime unknowingly, unpurposefully, or sometime it is beyond the limitation of a planner, there will be some threat. What will be just some threat? For sake of example, we had a pandemic, COVID-19, and we are unable to meet in the physical class. So we have thought of organizing an online class. But we know that this was the limitation, we cannot meet. There was an opportunity that these type of platforms are available, but there is a threat also. What are the threat? First threat, the threat to the data privacy. During that, so many things has come which become a threat for the privacy. You know that the case of Zoom and all those apps, so many app has been banned. Even the Google Meet also improved. So many things happened. So this is the one of, you are not purposefully doing that. You are not exposing the data purposefully, but sometimes it is beyond your control, because we don't have some app that is supported by the government. That's why when this pandemic came, then I was discussing with some of the professor, and I have talked. This is the right time when the government seriously think about developing this type of app and making available free of cost to the teacher and student. Like a Google Meet is there, so I'm making available, because we cannot rely on the others. Data is with them. Even the learning management system, we don't have an indigenous. Some indigenous we have, like on the MOOC. MOOCIT is developed by the IITs. One more I found, like Bodhi Tree is developed by the IIT. Some platform is there. But those platform are not available open. Like that the Moodle is available. Like that I have not developed much for this paper, but those who are for mathematics, pedagogy, they must be enjoying now, because all the contents are there. Even whatever I will teach today, it is available there. And whatever I will teach today, so the record will be available there. PPT will be available. Everything things available. For you people, from Monday it will be available. Because of the some disturbance, I could not able to do that. I am very sorry. I have thought of doing that. That's why I have invested so many things, even money, manpower, everything I have invested. But I could not. But my point is that since those things are available, so I can use. But these things that is developed by the government, it is not available to all. So many unnecessary procedures are there. In the name of misuse, what misuse we will do? It's a learning platform. It is designed in a such a way that those who are interested to use, they can only use for the learning. And learning can never be a misuse. So I was saying these are the inbuilt threat, like a threat that those who are not having ICT gadgets, like a poor children. So just think, what are their condition? Their 1 year, one academic year, 1 year is totally gone, because you have a laptop and a computer and all those things, mobile, and you can study. But what about the laborers' children? What about the migrants' children? What about the street children's? What about the slum children's? Their parents are also not that much motivated. So these are the inbuilt threat. Children are using the ICT gadgets for a long time. It is giving the adverse effect to their health, to their psychic mind. Psychologically, it is also adversely affecting eye health and the socialization process also. Because when I talk to my sister daughter, she is in class 8. Earlier, very frequently, she used to call me. Every day, almost, she were calling me, because she is very close to me. But nowadays she is not calling. When I will call in the evening after coming from all those things, she will say, "Mama, now I am busy in the doing the homework." When I will call in the daytime, so this is the online class time. So like that, she don't have a time. So it is adversely affecting the socialization also. It is adversely affecting the health also, mental health, physical, everything, which is not purposefully planned, but the threat is there. Threat is there. It is not purposefully planned, but the threat is there. So when we, the point of saying is in this SWOT analysis, the last one, the threat is there, you must try to visualize the threat. What could be a threat? When we will adopt this plan, I am not saying that if you will try to analyze, you will be able to visualize all the threat. You may not be. When you will implement, then you will be able to know the actual threats. It's quite possible. And it is also like that you will be able to handle all the threats. It may not be also possible. But as far as possible, we must try to minimize or remove, minimize the threats. And that's why the SWOT analysis is very much required. We must understand the opportunities within, the strength and a weakness, and we must have a plan. We must have a threat analysis also, and we must try to handle those threats, because if won't handle, it will be again problematic, and we try to minimize. Okay, so this was about the SWOT analysis. So we will have again that is a very small question answer session. I think some question I have got in the chat box. I will be going through that, and for other question you keep you may be prepared or you may type in the chat box. Shubhasri Mallik is saying identity, a person's identifying, I think you are trying to say identify a person's strength can help to achieve and help to avoid weakness. Weakness, yes, the first part is the very much right, that we must try to identify our own strength, in which area we are good, accordingly we should plan. Or if there is some area where I am not good, so we can hire someone, we can collaborate someone, because something is very much necessary. Like that nowadays the organization of online classes is very much required, because there is no other mean. And suppose that you are not very comfortable in that, so you can collaborate, you can hire, you can learn. Like that I will give you very good example. Like that our principal sir is not very much comfortable with these ICT gadgets. So sometime when the sir is asking, I have also assisted. Then most of the time Kulamani sir is assisting. That is the collaboration for the betterment, for the interest of the this profession. So like that. And then that avoid weakness. Weakness cannot be avoided, we cannot avoid the weakness, but we can minimize the effect of a weakness. Like that principal sir is getting help and collaborating, and then he is managing to organize an online class. So he has minimized the effect of something he is not having. Minimization, it is minimized. Then the next one is the strength, competitive capabilities, weakness, competitive deficiencies, opportunities, favorable factors, threat, unfavorable factor. Yes, it is quite good. It's good. Okay, then the other things, if anybody of you have a question or a query or a doubt, anything. Hello.
No sir. No sir.
Okay, so I am proceeding towards the yes, next sir. Thing.
Yes sir.
So these are the five steps, five phase to plan a school, to develop a school development plan. These are the five steps, one by one step we will be seeing. The first steps in the school development plan is the understanding the school and a community, because we know that the school is a miniature society, is the opposite of a society and a community, and a school represents the society and a community. So in order to have any developmental plan for the school, we must understand the school and the community. What are their specific need? What are the strength? What are the limitations? What are the opportunities are available there? That we must understand them. Without understanding the community, school and children, no educational intervention. I am talking about the educational intervention. It may be related to the educational management. It may be related to the teaching and learning process. It may be related to the any other things, will be successful. Without considering the school, community, and a children. So the first step is to understand the school community and a children. Then after understanding what is the specific requirement of that, we may have a dialogue, discussion and a brainstorming with the different stakeholder of the school, like a society, like the parents representatives, like a children, like members of a SMDC, like a members of a Panchayati Raj institutions, like a teaching faculties. We must have a dialogue, discussion and a brainstorming that these are the specific need of the school community and the children, and how we can make a provision for that, what kind of a plan may be required for that. And after having the discussion and understanding, then we have to devise an activity. We have to identify the activity. What activity is required to fulfill those requirement demands that we have brought by the discussion and a dialogue, by we have brought by the understanding the school and a community. So that we have to identify, and we have to chalk out the different school development plan. And then after planning, we have to implement whatever we have planned. And then after implementing, we have to monitor, because any activity, any intervention that we do in the any field, it is not only in the educational management, in any field, when we plan and execute activity, it requires monitoring, that whatever we have planned, whether the execution is going in a proper direction or not, whether the execution is appropriate or not, or what kind of hurdles and difficulties we are facing. Because this type of activity, when we think, plan and act, the measure is three things: think, plan, act. It always have a reflective mechanism that we use to reflect that whatever we have planned, how we have executed, and what kind of a reflection we are getting while executing, so that we can improve it in the next time. And that's why the feedback mechanism is inbuilt. And don't think that the feedback is only at the last time, at the monitoring phase. It is also at a first phase, second phase and a third phase. At each phase, the feedback will be there, so that when you will be planning at a next time, you will use those feedbacks. Okay, you will use those feedbacks to improve the situation. So, in basic, when we have a school development plan, when we are planning for the school development, these five phases we use to employ, that is understanding the school and a community, then having a dialogue, discussion and a brainstorming with the different stakeholders, then we use to identify activity for a school development plan, and then we are a planning team and implementation of identified activities, and then we are monitoring and getting a feedback. Okay, so I think that we should have a class up to here only. We will have a very brief question answer session if you have any, otherwise we will stop this session here. And those who are for the mathematics pedagogy, they may join me at 11 o'clock. Is there any question or a doubt up to here? Anyone, please? Okay, so since there is no question, so we are stopping this class here. Thank you for being with me. Have a nice day.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.